Hi friends, my name is Katie Robinson and today I am joined by a very special person on my channel. This is my sister.
Hello.
This is Emily. And today we wanted to talk to you a little bit about bridal showers and kind of planning a bridal shower, because I literally had like the best bridal shower in the world. Like, Emily absolutely crushed it and it was super great. And so I wanted to invite her on here to tell you guys a little bit about how she made the dream bridal shower happen. Okay. So basically we're just gonna kind of chat back and forth on some things that we think would help you guys as you're planning a bridal shower. I think one of the first things Emily wanted to share was maybe like budget tips and tricks or location tips and tricks, kind of just general bridal shower planning,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, definitely. So I think one of the first things you have to figure out is kind of how much you have to spend total, because that really will either limit you or allow you to do more things, and that's kind of vital to all of your planning. But for me, I knew I kind of had enough to work with that I wanted to have it at a venue. But for people who are thinking of having it at home, I've looked at tons of things, tons of examples, and that's totally a great option too. But for us, it was going to be in February, so it had to be inside, and really wasn't enough space to do it at home.
Love the idea, just gonna jump in, like for the summer, like the idea of on the lawn. Maybe having it at home and doing it on the lawn, yeah. Or like renting some chairs and tables and doing it in your backyard. Like, love that idea. Unfortunately, my birthday, my bridal shower, like all of these things always fall in the winter, so I can never do anything outside. But yeah. But go ahead.
So what I decided would work best is that our hometown is right near where we both, where I currently go to college and where Katie also went to college, and all her bridesmaids and those kinds of people also went. So since I'm still a current student, it was relatively inexpensive for me to rent spaces at our college. So I rented a beautiful place, which is kind of like a special house where they house guests and things like that, but it's very beautiful, kind of like an older, beautiful,
almost like a colonial style little cottage house at our college. It's really neat. It's for like VIP special speakers and guests. And
So I was able to rent that. So that was kind of, what is our topic we're talking about right now?
Are we talking about budget and like overall venue? Location tips and tricks?
Okay. Oh, money saving tips and tricks. Okay. I was like, where am I going with this? Okay.
That's basically me on every single YouTube video. I'm like, where am I going with this?
So by booking a space at our college, I was able to save a lot of money. It definitely, there were a lot of other venues I wanted to explore, but it ended up being a perfect space for us, especially since it was a smaller group. So I saved a lot of money that way, but another way it helped me save money was that I was able to use our college's catering services. And Muhlenberg College has the number 16 college campus food in the country, so their catering is phenomenal. And so I was able to use their services and also get a discount through that, which was really helpful. And then the rest, kind of as far as budget, is you really have to make lists and figure out what is most important. At the end of the day, things
this is
like
literally like I mean, you haven't even watched it, I don't think, yet, but like my with things I wish I had known going into wedding planning, that was like my number one thing was figuring out your budget with your fiance, and then next, like, prioritizing the most important things for you, so you at least can start that list from the top, and then all the extra things, like if you have money left over, great, but totally on the same page, but go ahead.
And kind of for me in planning, the things that I decided at the end of the day were most important were decorations, because Kitty, as we know, loves photos, things like that. I wanted it to be really aesthetically beautiful, and then also just like food, because everyone's gonna eat
Who
it, things like that.
Food.
Yeah. and so some of the ways I saved on that were I did a lot of the decorations kind of myself. For instance, like all of the favors, which we will put a photo up of, I ordered, but I hand put them together. I filled them myself, all those kinds of things. For the
flowers. Do you want to talk to people? We'll kind of like go on a tangent and talk about decorations, because your decorations were bomb.
We'll kind of talk about the decorations and the prices of them at the same time. So for all of the centerpieces, I did floral arrangements, but it was a mixture of fake flowers and real flowers from Trader Joe's, and we went to several different places to buy flowers, because some things are cheaper at some places and other places, depending on the flower.
Trader Joe's, grocery stores, right? Like Wegmans is awesome if you're in the north. Harris Teeter in the south.
I don't even know what that is.
Yeah.
and so also the vases that they were actually in. I saw these beautiful things with these glass ones, and they were all way too expensive. So my mom actually found, they were these little, like, kind of the, oh, you found them? Oh, yeah. I thought mom found them. They were these little, like, the brushed metal
looking. We'll insert a picture. They were so cute. They were, like, galvanized
buckets that said, like, flowers and things
Flower
like
market.
That.
They were, like, so cute.
And so they were really perfect. And then I did their arrangements myself the night before, which was very exhausting and chaotic in my very small dorm room. But I saved so much money by doing them myself and buying
They looked the adorable.
Flowers
they
ourselves.
They were so cute.
Yeah.
And the only things she really inserted that were artificial were like peonies because they're not in season in February, and they totally looked real. They were like the real feel ones from Michael's or whatever, so they were bomb.
Yeah, and then for most of the rest of the decorations on the extra tables and things like that, I used a lot of items that I already owned. Katie will put in the pictures, but for instance, in my bedroom, I have this beautiful blue, kind of like, it looks like a bird cage and things like that. Decorations from, that's from my bedroom.
Oh my God.
Like, things like that most Pinteresty people have around their house.
Like, she grabbed a couple
wooden crates.
Yeah, the wooden crate. There were like a couple like glass candle containers
and
where you have
that's
big powder
so the,
candles,
yeah, the rest
like,
the rest of the decorations I pretty much got from Hobby Lobby with their coupons they have online. Went on a lot of trips separately.
Yeah, if you plan things out, like use your Hobby Lobby and Michael's coupons every week, like go like every day if you can, or get your mom to or something.
Yeah. Other things, like I did a chalkboard sign myself instead of, you know, you can order these cute ones online, but I decided, okay, I'll buy a chalkboard sign, write it out myself. Things like that just kind of help you save money. But then I decided what were the big ticket items I wanted to spend money on. And I decided the first one was chairs. Muhlenberg provided,
They were so pretty.
Muhlenberg provides all of the linens, all of those kinds of things when you book a space through them, which was great. But the chairs in the space were hideously ugly. They're these bulky wooden chairs with this gross, like, floral pattern on them. And so I decided the thing I want to spend the most money on was ordering gold shibari chairs. That's what they're called, right? And it transformed the space. It made it absolutely fairy-like.
Oh, they were
beautiful.
So pretty. Yeah.
And then the second thing that I decided I wanted to spend a lot of money on was a garden wall backdrop for photos and things like that, and also just it was kind of a centerpiece for the room. And I looked up a lot of ways to make it myself and realized at the end of the day it was just going to cost almost as much as it would to rent. But around me there's a great party rental store. They're really helpful for all kinds of different things. I got the chairs from them too. And then to decorate that, I had in front of that big, like, what are those things called? With the candles inside.
Yeah, they were like wooden candles.
Lanterns,
yes.
On the ground. There will be pictures, I'm sure. And then I have a lady who does different balloon decorations, Tina. She's fantastic.
Tina.
Yeah, we love Tina. And so I got her to make a draped balloon decoration to
it's
go
like a balloon garland,
yeah,
basically
garland.
I've seen it with all the different size balloons. They're very in and trendy right now, and it looked incredible.
And there's all kinds of even fancier things you can do with balloons, which are a really great thing to do because balloons themselves are really cheap. And if you have the time to make it yourself, you easily can make them yourselves, garlands and all kinds of different balloon decorations. For me, I knew I didn't have the time because I was also in the midst of like midterms and things like that. So I didn't make it myself, but that's a good way to save money, and it's beautiful.
They look so cute in photos.
And it's a good thing I didn't make it myself because we were in a helium shortage nationwide at that time, and you couldn't buy helium.
So one of the other really fun things I loved about my shower compared to other people's showers is like the games at my shower were so much fun and really brought a lot of like interaction into it. Everyone was laughing the entire time, and they even did something really special for me at the end of like the games portion. Do you want to talk a little bit about the games?
Yeah, definitely.
And even like the one we didn't get to because we ran out of time having fun.
So kind of going on a tangent, one of the most important things about planning any event is delegating, because you can't do it all yourself. So I delegated most of the games to Katie's other bridesmaids, and specifically her roommates, her three roommates from college, because I knew they'd be fantastic at it. So we kind of talked a lot about different games, but we decided on a couple. First we did one where you have a list of, I don't know, 25, 30 things, like who listens to country music, whose favorite food is mac and cheese, things like that.
Who's gonna cry on the big day, yeah. Like, things like that.
And there's a Katie side and a Michael side, and you can order little printables on Etsy, online, you can make your own, things like that. And they were just, they had them at every place.
It's like bride, groom, mm-hmm. or both, and yeah. that's like, yeah.
And it was just a quick and easy thing to do when people were sitting during some downtime and they'd circle them. And then we went over them as a group, and I think I won. Did I win?
I think you won.
I won. Yeah. And then a couple other, you had prizes for like first place, second place, mm-hmm. those kinds of
the
things.
The people that got the most correct. So I was like the final verdict of like who would do which one. And then I think Emily ended up winning. Yeah. And knew us the best. But yeah.
Yep. And then we had another game that we planned to do and didn't get to, which mm-hmm. is toilet paper brides, which can be a really so funny one to do. Basically, you buy a lot of toilet paper and you split up into teams, and each team has their own bride, and you have a certain amount of time to use the toilet paper to wrap or drape some kind of dress. And
you literally have to make them a dress out of toilet paper that they can
Katie's
like, walk
especially
down
good
the runway
at this game. And we didn't get to that one because we ended up just like
it's really
doing
fun.
Too many things. That one was really fun. And then kind of, it wasn't totally a game, but one of the really, really sweet things that her roommates coordinated was that they basically sat down on Katie and they asked her questions. And like about their relationship, like how did you and Michael meet, this, that, the other thing like that. And
how
she,
many kids do you
yeah.
want? Like, where do you see yourself in 10 years?
Yep. Yeah. And she answered her part, and then we had set up a TV in the room, and beforehand they had gotten Michael's responses to all of these questions, because Katie was really sad that Michael couldn't be there, because yeah. that's not what a bridal shower is, but she really wanted him there. So we then played Michael's response to each question after Katie responded, and it was probably the most precious thing.
So
I think
cute.
Everyone there was in
so
tears.
So funny. Michael had like selfie stick to himself.
Yeah.
Like
he's really a much better vlogger than Katie is.
Yeah,
you
it was interesting. Really great. So any last things like you want to tell people about bridal showers or planning like perfect days?
Just kind of a big thing is to think ahead in the whole process, especially if you have maid of honor, but even as a bridesmaid or someone like that, it's important
Ooh,
to remember
tell them about guest book and
yeah,
like,
yeah, that's what I'm
going
to.
Oh, okay.
It's important to remember like what memories of like you're going to wish you had kept and things like that. So first off, mm-hmm. it's a common tradition that also commonly gets forgotten at bridal showers to collect all of the bows and ribbons from presents mm-hmm. and compile them into a little bouquet, yeah. Which then you can use at your rehearsal dinner.
Yeah, as you use it as your rehearsal as your bouquet walking down the
yeah,
aisle. Really
which
cute.
Is just a really sweet memory. It's a cute mm-hmm. thing to keep. As well as things like making sure you have a guest book so they can write notes. I even, when I sent out the invitations, I sent little cards out with every invitation that people could write advice or a sweet note or things like that, and the goal was to compile them into a scrapbook for Katie along with pictures mm-hmm. from the shower and the bachelorette party and things like yeah. that. So you want to make sure you're hanging on to the little items and things like that so that you can give them to the bride after all the craziness so she has those little memories.
Yeah, yeah. Well, anyways, if you guys have questions about bridal showers or like any maid of honor things, really, Emily was literally like the best maid of honor, like so together, she was awesome. You can definitely drop them in the comments below for us. This is kind of one of our
yeah, woo.
this is definitely like gonna go in that wedding planning series that I told you guys about. So if you have any questions, feel free to reach out, and I will have Emily hop on and kind of explain some of what she did to make my day so special. But if you're not already subscribed, make sure you hit the subscribe button below and tap the little bell to get updates. And thank you so much for joining us today. Bye, guys.